Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank Transparency International not only for the effort to organize this conference, but also more generally for its determination to campaign against corruption. From my experience, the main challenge in fighting corruption is to win the hearts and minds of the people, to show them again and again that the law applies to everyone, that justice is tangible. This is why a tool such as the Annual Corruption Perception Index is very useful. It maps an essential component of the rule of law, the citizens' trust in their institutions. The expectations linked to the establishment of the EPPO are very high across the EU. I know about the petition for Hungary to join the EPPO. Those 680,000 signatures are empowering and binding. What are the two things that you should know about EPPO? First, our assignment is to improve the level of protection of the financial interest of the EU. The EPPO will investigate fraud involving EU funds of over 10,000 euro and cross-border VAT fraud involving damage above 10 million euro. Second, we have a mandatory competence. Any fraud involving EU funds or serious cross-border VAT fraud committed in the participating member states after November 2017 falls within our jurisdiction. Please allow me to underline this particular point as it is often overlooked when talking about the EPPO. We have a legal obligation to investigate all new cases from the day we start operations. This means that we do not have discretion to investigate only a few significant cases based on which we could demonstrate our added value. I come to understand that many people still perceive the EPPO either as a new agency of the EU or as a pilot project, a proof of concept, something small, which, if it works, might eventually be scaled up. Well, for me, the reality of the EPPO is quite different. First, the EPPO is not an addition, a new layer to improve the coordination of national authorities. We are introducing a specialized prosecution office with unprecedented powers in the national judiciaries of 22 participating member states. Second, due to its mandatory competence, the EPPO has to well calibrate it. From the first day of its operation, it has to be able to deal with the whole relevant workload currently accomplished at national level. We are not supplementing, we are replacing. The immediate objective is to ensure a unified approach in the fight against fraud and crime affecting the financial interest of the European Union. Currently, there are significant discrepancies in the intensity of investigation and prosecution in this field among the member states. This is why it would have been preferable if all the member states choose to participate in the EPPO. The door is open for those that have not joined yet. It makes perfect sense from a practitioner's perspective, but in the end, it is a political decision. One of the main tasks of the European Public Prosecutor Office will be to help the member states recover the damages from criminal activities under its scope of competence. Of course, in full respect of the fundamental rights of the people involved in the criminal proceedings and of the procedural criminal laws of the participating member states. The EPPO is a completely new structure. There is no precedent. It will operate under 22 different jurisdictions, 22 different criminal codes, procedural codes, judicial systems. And yet, the EPPO will have to find a way to operate as a single office. Each of us comes with a specific background, language, culture, experience. I am not aware of a more exciting challenge for our generation. Of course, it will not be easy to find solutions for 22 different judicial systems, especially because there is no precedent for the European Public Prosecutor Office. We have to create precedent. Our work is that of a true pioneers. In practice, 22 European prosecutors in Luxembourg will oversee investigations initiated by the European delegated prosecutors in the participating member states. In addition, they will work in the 15 permanent chambers, taking key decisions in each and every case. We will have up to 140 European delegated prosecutors. They will be active members of the judiciary in their respective national systems, and they will be exercising the functions of prosecutors in front of the national courts. The greatest advantage of the PPO from an operational point of view is precisely in their ability to cooperate directly and quickly. Where until now, any prosecutor had to use the lengthy channels of mutual legal assistance to get information or evidence from another member state, the European delegated prosecutors will do it in direct cooperation between themselves. A phone call, an instruction in an APPO case management system will be enough. Finally, there is no doubt that the operational start of the EPPO will have a major influence on the overall anti-fraud architecture in the EU. It will introduce a progressive recalibration of the activities of OLAF, Eurojust and Europol when it comes to the protection of the financial interest of the EU. We have agreed on working arrangements with all of them. The cooperation between the EPPO and Europol will be of strategic importance. We count on a timely sharing of information and coordination of our respective analytical capabilities. This will be a crucial factor in the fight against organized crime. The EPPO will be able to share information related to relevant cross-border cases and to rely on Eurojust support in the relations with non-participating member states as well as third countries. As to OLAF, our respective mandates and competences are different. As a rule, where the EPPO conducts a criminal investigation, OLAF will not open any parallel administrative investigation into the same facts. The EPPO will also rely on OLAF to improve the current level of detection of EU fraud, both in speed and quantity, and also OLAF will of course continue to play a necessary role in relation to not participating member states as well as to the third countries. Ladies and gentlemen, the operational start of the EPPO will take place in a context no one could anticipate. The overall volume of the financial interests of the EU to protect has almost doubled, and we will have now our own resources. In the context of COVID-19 pandemic, I can say that more funds, more flexibility in using EU funds, unfortunately, also means opportunities for fraud and for corruption. There are a lot of reasons to believe that our jurisdiction will increase and also the number of the cases. But I am confident that and count on our fellow prosecutors, policemen, judges in the member states. But above all, we can also count on millions of European citizens who understand what is at stake here. As prosecutors, we just enforce the law. Our role is to set the wheels of justice into motion to ensure that everyone is equal in front of the law, that no one is untouchable. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you so much, Ms. Kövessi. I just want to check with you whether you can hear the English translation. I will switch to Hungarian. Szeretném ellenőrizni, hogy működik-e a tolmácsolás a Működik, szuper.
Yes.
Nagyon szépen köszönjük. Akkor a főügyészasszony beleegyezett, hogy néhány kérdésre egy 10-15 perces keretben válaszol kérdésekre. Közben itt a csatablakban már érkeztek kérdések, és azt szeretném javasolni, hogy 2-3 kérdést egyszerre összegyűjtenénk, és akkor utána adnánk meg a szót a főügyészasszonynak. Akkor először Hatházi Ákos képviselő úr volt, aki szót kért. Most meg fogjuk adni a kamera és a mikrofon jogot a képviselő úrnak, és személyesen tudja feltenni a kérdését magyarul.
Köszönöm szépen. A első kérdésem az egy szubjektív kérdés. Lát-e ön arra... Bocsánat, köszönöm szépen, egy szubjektív kérdés. Lát-e ön arra esélyt, hogy az Európai Unió kvázi kikényszerítse a magyar kormánytól azt, hogy csatlakozzon az ügyészséghez? A másik, egy problémára szeretném felhívni a figyelmet a társszervvel, az OLAF-fal kapcsolatban. Az OLAF úgy jött létre, hogy én véleményem szerint a legfontosabb feladatot nem tudja létrehozni, és nem az OLAF hibájából, hanem a szabályozás miatt. Gyakorlatilag, ha ő egy jelentést lezár, elkészít, akkor azt csak akkor ismerheti meg a közvélemény, hogyha azt az adott kormány megengedi. Gyakorlatilag az OLAF vizsgálatai a nyilvánosságot nem nagyon engedik meg. Ebben lesz-e változás, vagy ehhez képest van-e eltérés az Európai Uniós ügyészség munkájában? Köszönöm szépen.
Köszönjük szépen. Mivel ez egyből két kérdés volt, talán azt javasolnám, hogy megadnám a szót a főügyészasszonynak, hogy erre egyből reagáljon, és akkor utána lesz lehetőség a többi kérdésekre. Főügyészasszony, ön a szó.
Thank you very much for your questions. To the first one, I should insist that I'm a prosecutor, I'm not a politician. So as a prosecutor, I would like to work with all the prosecutors from the member states, but with all the prosecutors in the world, because we have the same goals, we have the same challenges. And in the end, we all want to have a good job and to work in the interest of justice, in the interest of the citizens. So I cannot comment any kind of political decision that any kind of government in the member states can take or should take. For the second questions related to OLAF activity, as I said, they will continue to make their investigations, but I should underline again the difference, the main difference that we have in this moment between OLAF and EPPO. OLAF can make only administrative investigations. EPPO will make criminal investigations. This means that we will investigate crimes, we will finalize the cases most of the time or part of the time with indictments, and we will send the cases in front of the judges in the national member state, in the member state. And of course, as any prosecutor office, we have to be transparent, but with some limits. Of course, our work can be found out in the statistics, because based on the regulation in each year, we have to have an annual report that will be sent to the parliament, to the council, to the commission. So in the end, the citizens will know about our work. I cannot comment about the work of OLAF, but it's important to say that we will work, we will complement our work also with OLAF, with Eurojust and Europol, because we are not in the competition. We have to work together and to try to protect better the European money.